Hello Heathens, and welcome to Heathen Hacks. I'm going to use an HDMI to VGA adapter from GigaWare, since both of my PC monitors don't support HDMI. Yep, been using these two for about 8 years now. Let's go! Okay, here you can see that I haven't installed anything yet. It's running on stock Android Nougat 7.1 OS. Please ignore the input not support thing that is flying around for the meantime. First, let's go to https://libreelec.tv/download/ to download the files that we need. Let's download the LibreELEC software that is needed to create a bootable SD card. Let's head to https://forum.libreelec.tv/thread/5848-8-2-2-3-libreelec-8-2-whatever. Now, look for these links and click them. They will take you to the files that we need for the LibreELEC bootable SD card creator and the device trees that will contain the folders with the .dtb files, which we will also need just in case the first method failed. I will click on 100 Mbit Ethernet since that's the one that my device supports. After that, I will download the gxm_9201_3.dtb because my device have 3 GB of RAM. Let's move on to the other link. Download both the LibreELEC S912.arm and so on, and LibreELEC S912.arm.tar. I think those are the main LibreELEC OS files. Not sure though. Now, locate all the files you have downloaded and transfer them into one folder to make it more easy. Before we proceed on the installation process, connect your SD card to the computer first. Then double click on the LibreELEC software that we downloaded earlier. Choose the generic AMD/Intel/NVIDIA x86_64 if your media box is not on the list. Click on select file, then find the LibreELEC S912ARM IMG zip. Then click write. After making the bootable drive, insert your SD card into the TV box. Then turn your device on. As you can see, in this scenario, my device did not boot up. No need to worry though, this is what the DTV file that we downloaded earlier is for. Now find the DTB file and rename it to DTB.img. Then click yes. After that, copy the file to the bootable drive and paste it. Then click replace. Then eject the drive and try to boot up your device again. Now, we're gonna do the same procedure as before. Insert the bootable drive into the proper port, then turn on the device. And there you go, it worked. Just wait for it to finish its configuration, then you can proceed to optimize LibreELEC and Kodi on your device as you like. Usually, after the procedures that we did before, it would boot to LibreELEC right away. But if both procedures did not work and your device just boots straight to Android instead of LibreELEC, even if the bootable SD card is inserted, here's what you can do. Alright, open up your browser, go to Google, type Terminal Emulator APK, and click on the first link that you'll see. Download it. And paste it inside a USB flash drive. Now, turn your device on, insert the flash drive, click on the app installer, find the name of your flash drive and install Terminal Emulator. Open it and type reboot update without the quotations. That will make your device reboot to LibreELEC. After that, you can just set it up according to your preference. Also, after installing LibreELEC successfully, you can't use the remote control of your device anymore without doing more research. So, you're going to need a Bluetooth keyboard or mouse. But don't worry, you can download the Core app on your Android or iOS device if you don't have one. And don't forget to download Thing so you can find your device's latest IP to connect to if you can't connect to the previous one. After downloading both apps, open Thing, click the refresh button. Here you can see that the device's IP address is 1.2. Now I'm using my K400 Plus keyboard with touchpad from Logitech, just to show that the one on Kodi is the same. Open the Kodi app. Click next to set up your media center. You can edit the name of your device if you want to. And if ever the last saved IP on your device is different than the one on Kore, you can use Ping to find the latest one. Then click Edit. Change the IP on Kore using the one on Ping. Then click Test. And there you go. You just need to organize your files. Please let me know if you have any questions and or suggestions, and if you want me to make a tutorial on how to make custom movie sets. Thanks for watching.